This is a use case diagram, and creating one is not so difficult, but takes time. I want to spend my time on more important tasks. And this custom GPT that is built specifically to create diagrams is going to help me do that. Let me show you how to use it. The custom GPT that I'm talking about is called Diagrams Show Me, and you might remember it from my previous video where we showcased the plugin. If you don't know what a custom GPT is, make sure to check out this video over here and then come back to this video. Alright, so in order to use this custom GPT to create diagrams, go to the following link: www.chat.openai.com/GPTs. And go to the search field and type in diagrams. And if it doesn't show up just yet, just add show me behind it. And then you'll see it. It looks like this. It's called Diagrams Show Me. And you can also just click on the link in the video description to take you directly to this custom GPT. Now we have the custom GPT open, we can have a look at the supported diagrams. Just click at the conversation starter at the bottom right corner. And when we click that, the custom GPT will explain us which kinds of diagrams we can actually make with this. And we also need to allow it to talk to the API. And you do need to have a little patience when you click on this, because it can actually take a little bit of time. But I will promise you that that is definitely worth it, because this custom GPT can create all kinds of diagrams for you. So let's have a quick look around. So as you can see, it can create sequence diagrams. And it will do so using Mermaid, which I also covered in a previous video, which you can check over here. They can create mind maps. And the interesting part about these kind of diagrams is that you can also edit them later. They can even create a timeline for you. Well, we're not really interested in these kind of diagrams because we were looking for a use case diagram. So I'm going to ask the custom GPT if it can create use case diagrams for me. And as you can see, it is going to talk to the API again and then come back with an answer. And it did come back with a use case diagram of a food critic interacting with a restaurant. Here you can see the interesting areas, because you can view this diagram full screen. And you can also describe the changes that you want to make in the chat, or you can just edit it by using the code. So let's see what will happen when we click on that. So going to the website, it basically displays the code. And right there in the code, you can of course change the variables. So let's say we don't want to call it a food critic, but a food influencer, if that is even a thing. And as you can see, it directly changed it right over here. So now we can just download this image and we're done. And in order to do that, we can click here right on PNG or SVG if we want to scale it. So let's click on SVG and see what the quality is like. So as you can see, now the SVG is on my screen, and yeah, it is a really simple diagram. So in my previous video, when we were creating use cases, it was a use case of a website selling shoes online that has a warehouse system as well. So let's use the same use case and see what this custom GPT comes back with. So I basically wrote, create a use case diagram for a website selling shoes online, which we call shoes. When the shoes are out of stock, they are put on back order for the warehouse. The warehouse manager makes sure the warehouse is always stocked by using the warehouse system, which is called wares. Let's see what the custom GPT comes back with. And as you can see, it is starting the action, which I have to allow, and it came back with an answer. So when we look at this use case diagram, we can see two actors, which is basically the customer and the warehouse manager. There are two systems involved, which is the website that we described, shoes, and the warehouse system. And the actions or the functionalities that are being described for the customer are purchasing the shoes, browsing the shoes, and actually it is automatically putting the shoes on the back order when it's like sold out. And when a shoe is on a back order, it will trigger the restocking of shoes, which is done by the warehouse manager in the warehouse system. This kind of gives you a good idea on how a shoe website is being managed. And of course, you can make it as detailed as you want. And again, if we wanted to edit this, we can just basically click on the edit functionality, and then it will take us to that separate website where we can change the variables. And now we are going to ask it to create a network diagram for me for the website selling shoes online. And as you can see, it basically came back with a network diagram. Let's have a look at the full screen version. You can see that in order to access the website, the customer will need an internet browser. The application, the website, the shoes online, is run on a server. And this server also has a product database. And of course, we cannot forget the payment gateway. So this diagram basically displays the basics that are required to run a web shop selling shoes online. Pretty cool if you ask me. So let's start a new chat and let's see how it does with sequence diagrams. All right, so let's create a sequence diagram for someone who orders a shoe online, all the way up to receiving the shoe at home. Wow, it basically came back with the whole sequence diagram, so let's dive into it and see if it actually makes any sense. And as you can see on the screen, it mentions the customer, the website, the payment gateway, the warehouse, and the delivery system. So basically all the actors that are going to interact with this sequence. And how you read this is basically the customer is browsing the shoes and selecting a pair. Then the website basically confirms the selection and requests payment from the customer. Then of course the customer makes a payment to the payment gateway, and the payment gateway confirms that payment in order for the shoes to be actually ordered. When the payment is successful, the website requests the shoe dispatch to the warehouse. And then the warehouse confirms that to the website. And what happens then is that the customer basically receives the shipping details. The delivery service will deliver the shoes to the customer. And when the shoes are received, then the delivery service will get a message. And one of the things that I see that is not included in this picture is that how the shoes actually get from the warehouse to the delivery service. So in order to add that, I basically asked the CustomGPT how the shoes get from the warehouse to the delivery service. And after that, it changed the image for me, as you can see right over here. So as you can see, this CustomGPT can create really good diagrams, saving you a bunch of time. And if you want to know more about creating use cases with the help of AI, make sure to watch this video over here. And then I'll see you in the next one. You're still here. Well, then let me tell you a joke. What do you call a robot that always takes the longest route? R2-detour?